Good morning, students. Yesterday we started new lesson, that is changes around us. We discuss about reversible change and irreversible change. Today again we will revise these points. Reversible change means in this the original substance will get back. For example, see here ice. When we heat ice, it change into water. Means totally state change. See first one ice. When we heat ice, it changes into water. Water is a liquid state. Okay, this change happened, but again this water after cooling again it convert into ice. Means the original substance, means this ice we are getting back. So this is the one example of reversible change. Here two arrows shows means first process, heating process, ice converted into water, and on cooling again water converted into ice. Now the second type of change, that is irreversible change. In this irreversible change means totally all the properties of the substance change. So burning of wood, so wood we will not get back. Okay, so this is the one example of irreversible change. So today we will discuss about how to make changes takes place. Okay, means how these changes occur, what is the reason behind this. So first one we will see the things become hot on heating and cold on cooling. Now this is very simple one. The things become hot on heating and cold on cooling. Suppose if you will take the water in this container, you will give the heat to this, then after some times you will see the temperature of water is increases. Means what? The normal water, the temperature increases and it, the hot water you will get. Okay, so these change occur because we are providing heat to the water. Okay, then second one, see, and cooling. Now cooling, this water, again here we discussed before also, say the water if you will get in refrigerator, after some time it will convert into ice. Why in refrigerator? Because water is converted into ice because their temperature is very less. In refrigerator you know that when water is converted into ice at 0 degree Celsius, liquid state, liquid converted into solid state. Okay, so things become hot on heating and cold on cooling. If you will provide heat, then it will become hot. This is the one example, water. But other examples, if you will take any metal, anything, if you will heat it, it will become hot. And if you will cool it, it will become cold. Now the second reason, that is the expand on heating and contract on cooling. Now here two words are different and new for you, that is the expand and contract. Now what is exactly expand? Expand means when you will provide heat to any metal. Okay, maybe iron, aluminium, so many metals are there. If you will provide heat to them, they will expand. Now expand means what? Increase in size. Expand means what? Increase in size. Means little bit the size is increases. Why? When you are providing heat to that. Suppose now see here, this is the iron bar or iron rod. If you will provide heat, then the molecules, you know, each every matter is made up of the molecules. These molecules start vibrating, and because of this, then after heating, little bit the size is increasing. Okay, when size increase means it is the expansion, and another it is the contract. It is totally opposite of expansion. Contract means what? Now you stop the heat and pour some cold water, or after some time when it will be cool, then again it comes into its original size. Means decrease in size. Contract means what? Decrease in size. So expansion and contraction, these totally depend on heating and cooling. Means these changes occurs because of the heating and cooling. Okay, now see more examples in your textbook. It is a given that is the fixing of iron ring and inserting of iron blade. The same thing, any metal, any heat you will take, if you will provide the heat, it will expand, and cooling, it will contract. So do you understand expansion and contraction? Only just remember, expansion means increase in size and contraction means decrease in size. Now next point we will see, that is the change their state. The same third word means change in their states. Okay, now change in their states mean the same thing. Now you see here, ice is in which state? Solid state. When you will provide heat, these ice converted